Thank you. Okay, so steel's now squared off. The next thing I'm going to do is blue them and mark them up. However, the first thing I want to do is work out the order of operation. There is an angle that has to be machined into one of the faces, and I'm thinking of leaving that till the last operation, because by introducing an angle, mounting it in the vise or wherever else I need to work on it will introduce complications with mounting. So the order of operation that I'm going to do is, there is a track that runs underneath that enables it to slide on the beam on the back of the lathe. That will be the first thing. Both will have those machined on. Then underneath there's a hollow area where the block that locks it onto the beam, where that goes in. So I'll make that piece second. And then I'm thinking what I might do is go onto the top and cut the slot for the T-slot. Once that's done, we have one large hole that goes all the way through for the center. There's also another hole, one in opposite ends on each block, to take the thread for the adjusting knob. That allows me to then wind the centers in and out. Now obviously one goes at one end of the beam, the other goes at the other. So the hole for that thread needs to be on the opposite end, depending on which block you're working on. No doubt I'm going to make that mistake. However, the last thing to do, there is another hole to be made, and that's where the locking knob fits in. However, it's probably going to be better to do that after the angle has been cut, because it's on the same plane as that angle. the slot on the bottom's done. T-slot has just been done. It's now a case of cutting the angle. It's a bit of a sketchy setup, this, but hopefully it should. It's rigid. Hopefully it should do the job. Let's see how I get on.